Thank you, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to give you a sort of a review or some thoughts about geothermal exploration. But I will start just to introduce my company or institution, ISOR, or Iceland Geosurvey, shortly. Iceland Geosurvey, or ISOR, was originally established in 1945. It is a non-profit governmental institution that is specialized in geothermal R&D. It operates on a competitive basis, and we have no basic governmental funding, so we are operating just like any other company. We have provided the scientific basis for the geothermal evolution in Iceland all the time since 1945. And now we have about 75 employees. These are mostly geoscientists and engineers. And on the picture there, you can see our first logging devices, an old Russian car, and some drums on that were used for the logging purposes. Apart from being very active and having been very active in Iceland, ISOR is very active internationally, and we offer complete geothermal services and consultancy in all over the world. And this map shows the countries where we have had projects in the past or have now. Presently, we are mostly active in East Africa, in Chile, and in Central America, outside Iceland, of course. But we are, last year, we probably were in, active in 10, 12 countries, something like that. And about 40% of our income is related to projects outside Iceland. What is geothermal exploration? By geothermal exploration, we mean acquisition of knowledge about possible geothermal field in order to identify a geothermal resource for a viable energy production. And we have several methods, and they include numerous geoscientific methods as well as drilling of exploratory wells. So geothermal exploration involves geoscience and exploration drilling. What is a conventional geothermal system? I will concentrate on exploration for such system. Primarily, we need a hot rock in the earth, and we need permeable fractures. These are the two conditions for creation of conventional geothermal system. And then we need to drill a hole, and our borehole must enter the hot rock, and it must also intersect the permeable fractures. If not, we will just get a dry well. So the purpose of geothermal exploration is to identify the hot rock and identify the permeable fractures to make the drilling successful and to estimate the size of the hot rock or a reservoir. And of course we need the power plant and the market, and then we need a fluid discharge, either naturally or by reinjection. So this is typical simple example of a conventional geothermal system. This is a picture showing, this is a theoretical picture showing total cost per energy unit as a function of average well output from a geothermal well. The green curve shows if we are harnessing our field with a binary system, the red and the blue, which coincide, is based on utilization of last condensing plant. And you can see that the cost per, in euro cents per kilowatt hour, is very dependent on the average well output. So for a case of the condensing plant, we can expect, say, 3.5 euro cent production price if we have only 2 megawatts per well. But if you are up to 5 or 6, we are down to 2.5. So this makes a hell of a difference of the production price. And therefore, the important thing is to lower the cost, reduce the number of wells that are needed per given plant. And to do that, we need a careful exploration. We know that a deep exploration borehole in a high temperature field costs several million US dollars. And you know that the total cost of geoscientific exploration is only a small part of cost of one such well. But you know that the exploration requires a considerable upfront cost prior to the exploration drilling, and therefore the methods must be selected with respect to the site. The exploration must be carried out in a professional manner, and that this is often something that is not taken well enough care of. And we always recommend a stepwise approach, that is, the strategy must be revised as the result of its geoscientific exploration methods start to appear. So it is not very wise to just stick to a fixed exploration program and not change it as the results come and require indeed such a change. The selection of exploration methods, we know that the geology of the geothermal field, they are quite variable from one place to another. So there is no single exploration procedure that can be applied universally to all geothermal fields. And this is very important to understand. This means again that the selection of exploration methods must be tailor-made for each field, for each case. But we have some guidelines to form suitable exploration strategy for each field we are going to explore. We can say there are roughly six steps in the geothermal exploration. From the start, if we start completely from scratch, we start by reviewing of the existing data, and then we go for a reconnaissance, a site visit, and to just to look roughly at the conditions of the site and decide if you go for further exploration. And then we start with the geological exploration and the geophysical exploration, and then finally we go for exploration drilling, and it gives us the preliminary resource estimate. Also, we do some preliminary resource estimate immediately after the geophysical exploration, prior to the exploration drilling, in order to decide if we should go for exploration drilling at all. And these results of these studies, they are analyzed in the pre-feasibility study of a given field. There are a variety of methods that are used. If you look at the geological and the geochemical exploration, this includes mapping, geological mapping, studies of the structural geology, the faults, the fracture that might be permeable. We must look at the volcanology in case of the high temperature field, the volcanic history. We must look at the hydrogeology at the site. We must evaluate possible geohazards and the environmental geology. And we must take samples to use geothermometers to estimate the reservoir temperature and the chemical properties of the fluid that we can expect. And we have questions to answer, like, does the surface activity, if it is visible at all, relate to some geological structure? What is the temperature of the geothermal reservoir? And is the chemical content suitable for geothermal exploration? In the geophysical exploration, there are exist variety of methods, but the most important one is the resistivity. But also, we can have methods like microseismicity studies, heat flow studies, gravity and magnetic studies, and seismic reflection, which is usually only recommended in case of sedimentary rocks. And we go from this, we get the answers, how big can we expect the active resource to be, and to define the drilling targets. Define the drilling target for the geothermal exploration wells. The important resistivity measurements, are the best available methods that we have for geophysical exploration for at all in the high temperature fields. And this is the only method that is sensitive to directly to geothermal properties or rock-like temperature. There are mainly two types of resistivity measurements, the TEM method and MT method, and they should always be used together. But this method, of course, like all geophysical methods, has limitations, and there are pitfalls that must be avoided. And these pictures are from one from Iceland and one from Eritrea, showing the field work in geophysical resistivity measurements. Ideally, for each high temperature field, we have a very simple or some principle of the geothermal or the resistivity structure of the field. This is usually so. We can say we have the field on the surface. You can see probably hot springs. We have high resistivity on the young volcanic rock close to the surface. Then we have a sort of a conductive, very conductive, low resistivity cap with clay-rich rocks, and these rocks are formed at 50 to 200 degrees centigrade. And then we have an inner core of high resistivity, and this core is formed where the temperature reaches 230 degrees roughly. So if we map such a structure, we can say that this surface denotes the area where temperature has reached 230 degrees centigrade. So this is the beauty of the resistivity measurements when they are applied in the volcanic fields, and most of the high temperature fields in the world are of volcanic origin. It is important to know that this resistive core shows the volume where the temperature has reached at least 230 degrees centigrade for some period during geological history of the geothermal field. So this is indeed our reservoir. But it is not necessarily so hot today. This hot resistive core, if it cools down, the resistivity will not lower correspondingly. This can only nowadays be tested by drilling. And therefore, the resistivity do not tell us exactly where to drill to obtain 230 degrees centigrade, but it tells us where not to drill. So we should focus on our exploration drilling of the area where we have this resistive core. And we need new and improved method to predict the temperature variation within the resistive core to be able to locate the first exploration well in a more targeted way than it is possible to today. But we should note, the nature is never as simple as indicated on the previous slides. Usually it is much more complicated, and the resistivity picture that appears are not as simple as I showed you when we get this from the real surveys. And this raises two issues. Is the method applied, both the measurements and the interpretation technology, sufficient and of high enough quality? And we should always think about the quality. It is not enough just that somebody goes with some equipment to measure the resistivity of whatever method we are applying. It needs to be done in a professional way, and there must be a very good quality control of the data that are collected. I have seen a lot of examples of companies collecting data, developers collecting data, but the data are poor, and probably the developer do not recognize or are not aware of this poor quality and take poor decisions based on that. And the question is, how do we interpret the real resistivity structures in terms of geothermal parameters like temperature, salinity, minerals, magma, and permeability? And because this is such a complex thing, we need communication and feedback mechanism between the exploration teams or those who are running and making doing the exploration and the decision makers, the developers. Because we have to change our road It is very often that we have to change the road in view of the results that we are getting, and therefore the developer must be able to talk to the exploration people. The real resistivity section over a geothermal field is shown on this picture, and this is just an example, field example, and rather simple field example. This is the low resistivity core, the conductive core, showing the clay minerals. Then we go to the blue color, and the blue color shows the resistive core where we have temperature over 230 degrees. And these are wells that have been drilled into this reservoir, and these green colors on the wells, they are on this picture showing the alteration minerals that tells us that we are within the resistive core, so they show a good coherence between the measured resistivity from the surface and what we get from the borehole. And on the same picture here, we have plotted the resistivity, the temperature of the wells, and we see this is everywhere about 230. And then we have this strange low resistivity body coming from depths and going into the reservoir. And we really do not know what this means. This is low resistivity. It could be some sort of a magma. This could be molten material or just only a very hot stuff. And we need still exploration, we need some more basic research to be able to conclude what causes a variation in the resistivity within the reservoir itself. Because we do not know exactly, for instance, how the resistivity within this resistive core, how it varies, for instance, with temperature. Going to the importance of basic research, I think I can state that the ultimate profitability of a geothermal project, it depends on the total cost of boreholes needed. That is the main uncertainty. How many boreholes do we need for a certain amount of energy? To reduce the cost of a geothermal power plant, we have mainly two possibilities. Either we can lower the drilling cost of individual wells or reduce the number of wells that are needed for a given amount of energy. To lower the drilling cost is an ongoing discussion always. It might be done by improved drilling technology and improved well design, suitable material selection with respect to the geothermal conditions, and optimizing the drilling procedure and the enhancement technology of the boreholes. To reduce the number of wells needed, we need better exploration methods and quality control of the work. We need better understanding of the geothermal processes and the methods we have to apply methods in a very targeted way, and we have to learn from failures. It is often so that you have made some geological model, you drill, and you have unsuccessful well, and then you just stop and you do not draw your conclusion from the failure that has happened. So go to my concluding remarks. The future of the profitable geothermal energy production relies on improved knowledge. The improved knowledge, it will only be obtained by well-targeted basic research covering a wide range of basic science, including physics, geosciences, chemistry, material sciences, and mechanical engineering, and including, of course, dissemination of the research. We have to put together in a pool all the knowledge we have from the universities, from the companies, from the research institution, to build up a strong basis for the geoscientific exploration. And this got me recognized by the geothermal industry as well as national and international funding bodies. And for us that are living in Europe, we have big faith, or we must rely on the European Union, the framework programs of the European Union. And therefore, it is important for the industry in Europe and for the research and people in Europe, institutions, to join forces and try to form European European industry initiative in the future to concentrate on better exploration and better development of the geothermal energy. Thank you.